Man, Cousin Chris, this is an incredible newspaper. I remember this well from year 2000. Your mom found these, right?
She did. She cleaning out the shit today. Man, this is some pretty cool stuff.
I know this guy right here on the front. He's a good friend of ours. He passed away several years ago. Jimmy Knupp.
Wow, that's
a great guy.
That's some pretty cool stuff here. Looking at some of these, you got high school seniors from 2000. Wonder what these guys are doing now, off out in the world doing big time things.
I remember this Chuck Hansen. He was the president CEO of Pilatex. He wanted to recreate the big neon sign and put it back on top of the mill.
Man, I wish that could have happened.
Whatever. Yeah, man. That would have been awesome.
Wow.
But
didn't
happen.
This guy right here, that's a true mill guy right there.
Yeah, it is. That eyeglass pocket thing in his pocket, whatever you call that. Holder.
Harold Farmer. It's 45 year service pen.
Swannanoa.
It's from Swannanoa. Oh, okay. I was gonna say. He looks like a fixer, but he is a foreman.
He's not a Kannapolis guy.
No, but he's a mill guy.
He's a mill guy.
Wow. Common threads. That's pretty cool. That is pretty cool.
So this would have been, this replaced the Cannon News.
So. Man, it sure did. And look at this. Look at this little folder.
Man, that's cool.
My mama was part of the Tau Operation Safety Committee. That's pretty cool.
Let's see. I was looking to see if we should we know. Oh, yeah, there's a Plant One anniversary. M.D. Ford, Carl Ford's dad, 45 years. I know some of these people.
Wow.
Wow, that's cool.
That woman there was my step-grandmother growing up. Doris Sims.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, right here?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Sure enough.
How about that?
How about that?
Wow. It's a throwback, man.
Sure is. Cool,
well,
man.
I guess we better get on episode, and we're back in history.
Oh, hey, here. I got you a sun drop here.
Man, I can't drink this.
Drink it.
It's from 1993,
crack it
man.
Open. Drink it.
I can't ruin it. It's a
no, man. Drink it. I want to see if you survive.
Let's see. Yeah, but then you'd have to do these shows on your own. Let's see. There it is. Maybe. Joe Farinello know who what that is.
Oh, yeah. How about that? Well, hey, 29 of these shows. Man.
Kevin Harvick.
Kevin Harvick. Three for Dale.
Yeah.
Just time keeps on flying by. Been a lot of fun stuff going on here in town. I had a good Veterans Day week last week, and ESPN.
That was a couple weeks ago.
The whole ESPN crew that was here. I finally got a chance to see the shows over there at Old Armor. That was pretty cool.
That was really cool. Showed the town. They said Kannapolis was the most patriotic city in America.
I believe
when the show came on. That was really an awesome honor to get deemed that.
I mean, and the submarine crew.
Center. Yeah, submarine crew.
The squad three, the Intimidators. Man, that was pretty cool.
Man, that was great. And Dale Jr. was part of that broadcast as well. And he, you know, talked on the show. And, of course, Kerry was a big part of that show getting produced and made. So it's awesome to see all those folks reconnected to Kannapolis. And, of course, our friends over in Mooresville had a good segment there with Richard's Coffee Shop. And it was just a great show. Thanks to guys at Old Armor for helping coordinate that.
Cool. Speaking of coffee shop, we were over at Editions this morning. We'll give a shout out to those guys. Bought a couple more copies of David Wisnett's book. So I thought that was a good little pit stop for us today.
Yeah, man. David's done. He's been everywhere with that book.
He has, and again, you know, he was on the episode a few weeks ago. So if you haven't got it, that was a really good book. So go buy that.
He's
that
a
book.
Great guy. Man.
Really, really good book. Man, we made a trip over to Brothers Tire today. Saw our good friend Todd. Gave him a shirt.
Gave him a shirt. Yeah, that's cool. Great. Cool. He can represent too.
Absolutely. No sticker.
I gave him a sticker too, Ben. I actually gave him two. Their store's so big, he's gonna put a couple of them up on the window.
Nice.
Yep, absolutely. Well, Ryan, what's on the agenda for today's show?
Yeah, we have a really good friend of the shows and, of course, a friend of family for many, many years. His family has been and just a real staple here in Kannapolis for so long. Caleb Falls is going to be joining us today, and he's kind of taken on some other roles in downtown as with the relocated or second store in Kannapolis
being
opened here and him being a part of our the fabric makes up downtown again. So.
Absolutely. We'll go get Caleb on here in just a minute. But let's play that intro and let's get to it. You ready?
All right, I'm ready.
All right.
Let's do it.
All right, guys, welcome back here. Episode number 29 of the K-Town Connection. The Rough Talk Cousins are at it again. I'm Chris Hughes, joined by my identical cousin, as I like to say, Ryan Dayvault. Rough Talk, Ryan, you ready to bring our guest in?
I'm ready, man. Let's do it.
All right, Caleb Falls, if you can hear me out there, come on down. You're the next contestant here on the K-Town Connection. How you doing, Caleb?
What's going on, man?
You want
a sun drop?
Yes, hey,
you want this one?
I will pass on that one. I'll take a first one. How about that? There you go.
Oh, we like to play a game. If we do ring the bell, you got to take a swig of Sun Drop.
All right.
Oh, wait. Hey, here. We got a K-Town Connection branded. It's all about branding.
It is.
Yeah, we got to show the brand.
We got a K-Town Connection branded drink opener.
We'll give you a shirt after this. And yeah. Then you can be representing too.
That's great. Awesome. Man. I appreciate you guys having me on.
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah.
Glad to be here. I know Ben's probably going to want you to slide down just a little bit more. There you go.
Right. He's picky. Good, Ben?
He's very
picky. As long as you're right behind the microphone is what really matters.
Perfect.
Love it.
I'm here.
So how you been, man?
Good. Busy. Busy's a good thing.
Good. Gearing up for Christmas season.
That's it. It's coming up, coming quick. Business is good, though.
Oh, good.
Thank the citizens for that. You know, I know you mentioned it. We've been here a long time. My great-grandfather, my grandfather, my dad, and, you know, we're just keeping that legacy going, my brother and I, and I'm glad to be here back in downtown. And like you said, just got a lot going on, but it's a good thing, and trying to help support and maintain this beautiful city we all love. So.
That's great. And yes, y'all's sir. Family started in the space right below where the studio's at.
Right
that's
under. It.
Right beneath us, yes, absolutely. The jewel shop, you know, it was my great-grandfather who started that. And it's pretty cool, that whole legacy and just where we've been and where we are now and where we're heading to as well. So pretty excited about that.
Now, you had a store over there at the Target on the other side of town, the more industrialized side of town. Mm-hmm. But now you're back here in the heart of downtown, you know, right in the former Mill Village, Cannon Village, right here on West Avenue. What's it like, man? Is there always a steady flow of walk-in traffic? And can you just feel a different energy?
Absolutely, 100%. You know, obviously growing up, I was around when it was still Cannon Village, and I know my dad was here. I mean, he gave his heart and soul, and still does to our business and to this city. I mean, it's where he was born and raised. Of course, following his dad and his grandfather's footsteps as well. My mom supporting him, being by his side through it all, and you know, the last thing he wanted to do was leave. You know. We went from the archways where the florist, Lucky's Florist, is right now, relocated to where Local Patriot is. So we had a storefront in there, which is pretty wild to walk in there, grab a cup of coffee, and think we should sell diamonds out of that store. But, you know, we're there till about 2010 and tried everything we could. But, you know, we had to relocate. So we do have that store still over at Afton. Mm-hmm. It's a great store for us, too. Business is doing well over there. But once, you know, downtown revitalized and, you know, what we see now, I told my dad, I said, Dad, could you think of another jewelry store going back in Kannapolis if it weren't us? And that I think to me, that's what was kind of the main thing for our family was like, you know, this is where we started. This is where our roots are. And we had to come back, you know, and we're very fortunate, very blessed to be back. and to answer your question, Chris, yeah, the foot traffic's great. I mean, you know, we've built so much, and there's so much going on. There's so much buzz around town, and where we've been, where we are now, where we're headed to, and you know, the sky's the limit, really, with everything that's going on in Kannapolis. So we're very excited.
Seems like yesterday that you and I and your brother and your dad and mom met for lunch one day and had that exact conversation before it all happened.
I remember. And, oh yeah, like it was yesterday. And, it's
that was great.
Time flies.
Time flies.
Yes, sir.
Wow. And then y'all have a beautiful store in the old JCPenney's location there on West Avenue. Well, thank you.
We had the perfect location when Ken and Kent approached us about it, and you know, the city, you guys too, and just seeing all that transform into what it is now, and again where we're heading, and just, you know, everything. We've felt the love from so many people and from the city, and just you guys, and I mean everybody, and again, we obviously wouldn't be Falls Jewelers without Kannapolis.
Yeah, so. Well, y'all did a charm last year, or was it this year?
We did. We did it last year. I'm actually wearing it on my wrist. We did a little memento to Kannapolis. We've got kind of highlighted, obviously, you know, Dale Earnhardt or NASCAR. I got the old smokestacks, the new baseball stadium, the research campus, the A.O. Brown K on it. It's just a cool little memento to Kannapolis. So we sell those now in the store. We try to do them as many different things as we can to, you know, for men, at least as far as like bracelets go, like I'm wearing, or pendants for ladies, or heck, we've had some people using for golf ball markers. I mean, you name it. Cool. So it's a pretty cool little charm that you can check out at Falls, and both stores sell them. So it's a cool, man, cool little piece.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I'm going to rewind for just a second.
Yeah.
You know, you're talking about your family and your rich history here in town, and you know how it couldn't have been anyone other than the Falls family to mm-hmm. bring a jewelry store back here to downtown. Mm-hmm. Tell us about your childhood growing up. Like, what was being a kid in Kannapolis like for you? Because, you mm-hmm. know, we all grew up here in town and in mm-hmm. different communities, different little neighborhoods, mm-hmm. and we all have our own unique stories. What was it like for you growing up?
For me, it was just, you know, I went to Shady Brook. I grew up in the same house. I mean, my parents still live in now, right down the street from Shady Brook, and you know, it's a 5-minute drive from here, and everything was right here. Went to church down the street at Kimball Lutheran Church growing up, and you know, everything was here. My dad worked here, my mom worked in the school system, so I mean, you know, a lot like you guys, Kannapolis was mm-hmm. all I've ever known, really. Mm-hmm. But it, you know, my childhood was so good. It was awesome. Obviously, I've always been really close with my family, my older brother as well, and I mean, I just remember growing up, coming, you know, my when my dad had one of his first locations on West A Street, I'd come with my mom and my brother, and we would go set up shop, a little picnic area right across from Dale, and always have lunch and come see my dad at work and hang out. And man, he had the coolest basement in the bottom of his store. And I remember snow days. I mean, just coming in when we didn't have school, Spencer and I we'd bring in our PlayStation and all of our little games, and you know, just hang out at the bottom of my dad's shop and just have a good time. I mean, you know, walking around. Again, growing up at Kimball, we would have lock-ins and we'd play all kinds of games around town. And, you know, it's just the whole community aspect of it. And, you know, I think a lot about where again, the city's been, just this downtown, the changes that have happened and how drastically different it is, mm-hmm. but in such a good way. I mean, you know, what you know, how good can it get, you know, for something to be here that was so prosperous? And then, of course, when the mill shut down, a lot of people, you know, that was not a good time for us. But for us to do a complete 180 and, you know, do something completely different, but look at what it is now. And while even on the show, you know, we're talking about where we're heading, but we honor where we've been, you know. Right. And that's, I feel like that's what it's all about. And if you're not really from Kannapolis or you haven't been here a long time, you really don't know how important this town is to so many people. I mean, myself included. So, you know, when people ask me where I'm from, I'm gonna darn right say Kannapolis.
Absolutely.
You know,
yeah. You'll never hear me say Charlotte.
That's right. No. That's right. That's right. So, Kannapolis, man, it's super important, and I couldn't think of another a different childhood other than growing up in Kannapolis. So.
Wow. Hey, that's ringing the bell on that
cheers
one.
To that
one. Yeah, cheers. Sundrop, the official beverage of us here at the K-Town Connection. Our favorite beverage, also the favorite beverage of
Dale Earnhardt.
There you go.
The godfather of the show, the mm-hmm. Citrus Taste we go wild for. Did you go to skating rink as a kid?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Skating USA. I remember skating nights, Tuesday nights. Man, if I wasn't going, my mom or dad wouldn't take me. I was not a happy kid, so...
still there.
Oh, yeah. I haven't been in a long time, but I've
loved to go
back.
What about the Pizza Hut for Book It?
Yeah.
You know, oh, yeah.
Book Club.
Pizza Hut.
Yep.
What about the Whataburger? We got this little red phone right here. It goes right to them.
Right, the number 10.
It goes to number 10.
Call them in now.
Yeah, call our friends. Lindsay and the crew. And
Alex. And
All of them.
Ellie.
We ain't seen them in a while. We need to go there tonight.
We'll see.
All right.
We'll see.
Been a minute. Well, cool. Well, Ryan, you got any questions for me?
Well, I guess, Caleb, your role now sort of from a civic side, you've teamed up with what used to be called and still is called Downtown Kannapolis Incorporated. It was kind of shelved for a long time as the town kind of was reborn, if you will. But, I remember being one of the initial people in that group when it started probably 10 years ago, I guess, and 15 years ago, maybe. I don't even remember when it was. But, it's came back. You've kind of stepped in as president, I believe.
Yes, sir. Yep.
So I guess tell us a little bit about that and what you're trying to do with that and the impact you intend on having.
Yeah. So I am, again, president of DKI, very fortunate to be named that and elected that. What we are really is just an organization, a nonprofit that represents many of the businesses in downtown Kannapolis, but also really within the loop. It is called DKI, but it's also kind of the greater, downtown Kannapolis region as well. I know you guys shout out Additions earlier. They're part of our group as well. A couple of the other businesses on kind of the outskirts of the downtown area. But really our main goal is to just to bring excitement and continue the excitement in downtown, bring awareness to downtown, all the local businesses, keep that in the forefront of people's minds, especially entering into the holiday season, right? To the importance of shopping small and really what that means to so many people. When you shop small in our community and you support our businesses, it not only does it mean the world to the people that own the business, but, it's all about the economy and working our community and being that person that remembers to shop small instead of, going online. And, I know it's so easy, and I do it too, right? Everybody loves Amazon. Everybody loves, the online stuff, but when you shop small, and that's what DKI is, it's remembering and telling people to shop small, bringing awareness to our businesses, and bringing people into Kannapolis. We do a lot of different social events. We try to do those about monthly, every month or so, just to bring people in to do some fun activities for kids, family friendly. Do what we can to again just bring people in to have them, make sure they have a good experience when they come into downtown. Yeah. We do our best to represent the city very well within our own businesses and as a collective group as well. And, the end goal is just to get everybody on board to kind of group together as one Kannapolis. That's what we are. And there's only one of us, right? Only one Kannapolis. And so the goal is just to get everybody a part of DKI and to represent the city as we all know and love it as best as we can. So
I know it was started, like in 20, I'd say probably like 2010 or 11, 12, somewhere in that ballpark. Guys like Tom Bennett, Gene Long, Daryl Jackson were kind of the founding group, as I remember. And as they coordinated some pretty big things when it started, the Rhonda Vincent concerts that were held at the Gym Theater brought in a ton of people, bluegrass show, and they were just awesome.
Yeah.
So, it kind of started as like a hyper-local chamber of commerce, if you will. From what you just said, I think it sums it up. If you're talking about everything within the loop, that's not just downtown, but that's kind of, it's a larger region, but it's sort of focused around downtown.
100%.
And, some of those guys that I mentioned earlier, their businesses were on the more of the periphery, North Kannapolis toward Concord, Tom, and it's good to see somebody putting effort into that and kind of bringing it back in a way that you're trying to.
Yeah, sure. It's we resurrected this organization, and we're kind of in the midst of continuing what they once did, but also kind of rebranding it to now we have the success that we wanted. Right, that's what DKI was made for, to bring these businesses in. And so now we have that. So how do we sustain that? And how do we bring everyone together? And how do we support each other while also supporting our citizens and bringing in, outside folks that don't necessarily live in Kannapolis? What's going to attract them in? keep them coming back to, having fun events and exciting events for them and their families to want to continue to come see us, to shop with us, and to, you know, again, ultimately fall in love with Kannapolis like we all do. So, right. Yeah.
And that's cool. Mm-hmm. Kind of shifted around in another initiative that you guys have started. You know, now we're into November. You know, mm-hmm. It's cold. We had to wear our jackets in tonight.
That's right.
You know, it's definitely tis the season, you know, mm-hmm. a week or so away from Thanksgiving. I noticed you guys are starting to put Christmas lights out and about town and encouraging the business owners mm-hmm. to put lights up as well,
yeah.
Which beautiful. I love it. I love the concept. Yeah. And just kind of gives us that festive, warm, inviting mm-hmm. Feel to people, because there's always, it don't matter if it's evening or not, people are always walking through the streets at
Absolutely.
Night. But tell us how that's gone.
Yeah, it's been great so far. You know, yeah, we've got the initiative to kind of just get everybody on board with it, just putting some lights up. It's pretty simple, but if we all do it and it looks cohesive, and I think it'd be a really good compliment to what, you know, the city puts on over at Village Park. That's such a true, you know, sight to see for a lot of folks around. And, as business owners and as the downtown region, we're just trying to think, how can we complement that? How can we continue to kind of keep the party going for folks that, you know, go to Village Park and make their way over to downtown to shop locally again with all of our businesses and, you know, just to give them a nice family-friendly, you know, atmosphere with, obviously, you know, the kids love the lights. I love the lights. I mean, you know, if you don't like Christmas lights, then, you know, I don't know what. But, you know, everybody likes them. And again, the goal is just to kind of get everybody on board with it, that's to cool. You know, display some kind of lights and to bring people in and have them make them have a good time and bring them coming back. So
I remember, you know, not in the, I wouldn't call them the prime years of downtown, mm-hmm. but not too long ago, before all the businesses left downtown, they would do the carriage rides with
mm-hmm. I do remember
horses
that.
And, you know, dressed up, as Christmas spirited, you know, ribbons and bows and mm-hmm. Stuff. And that was always cool. People mm-hmm. came for that, and they would always have Santa Claus in the visitor center and,
yeah.
A lot of, you know, hot cider in the visitor mm-hmm. center back then
yeah.
and just
yeah.
all sorts of little things that Castle and Cook, you know, Murdoch's company did back mm-hmm. in the day when they were pushing Cannon Village as a concept.
Mm-hmm.
And
yep.
I remember,
you know, it'd be nice to see some of that stuff come back.
For
and,
sure.
I know you're working on a beard there. I mean, you could dress up as Santa Claus.
Yeah, just gotta get it white.
Get it white,
out a little more, get it white. And
well, this is episode 29. What are you, 29?
29, yeah.
Yeah, see there.
There you go.
The stress
turn 30,
coming.
That's going to be
yes,
it, you know.
Game over at that point.
Hey, let's take a quick break here, and we'll come back, and we'll talk some more of these K-Town memories with Caleb Falls. We'll be right back.
For four generations, Falls Jewelers has provided the finest selection of jewelry and comprehensive repair in Kannapolis and Concord. We can design and craft beautiful jewelry from diamonds we've personally hand-selected from Antwerp, or have our certified bench jeweler repair your pieces right in our location. Falls Jewelers is committed to giving you great service at a great value because we believe you deserve it. Falls Jewelers in Concord and Kannapolis, where everyone falls in love.
All right, hey, coming back from the break, let's do another
there you go.
Sweet
cheers.
Sun drop. Hey,
sounds
cheers.
Good. Cheers, guys. Yes, sir.
Episode 29. I have cut them out. I can have about one a week, but it's hard to not have my sun drop every day. But that's a good one right there.
I've rough talked him into having this one.
That's
hey,
right.
Going back to, you know, some of our memories and talking about the carriage rides in downtown. I even remember there used to be commercials on TV the carriage rides and mm-hmm. stuff like that. You might be old enough, but I don't think you are. But were any of you old enough to remember when they had Santa Claus in the lake right here?
Oh, yeah.
In front of the mill.
Mm-hmm.
Are you talking about the lights? Or?
Yeah, it was like Santa Claus, a lit up Santa Claus that floated in the lake with some Christmas trees right here.
Before the cannon. Before the cannon.
I remember the cannon.
You remember the cannon?
I remember the cannon. I was going to say, you know, we were talking about memories and growing up earlier and. Yeah, I mean, like, as a kid, you know, the cannon was there, so mm-hmm. driving by, man, you see that cannon.
And the soldiers. Like,
yep,
yeah,
and all that, man.
You know, all that's at Village Park.
Absolutely,
you know?
Absolutely.
Most people have kind of forgotten that.
Yep, but. And I love that the city does that, man. You know, for me, again, as a kid, seeing that out there on the lake, and, of course, it's not on the lake still, but to still have it around mm-hmm. and to be able to go see it every year with my family now mm-hmm. and my kids, you know, it's meaningful, and it's very, very cool.
The city, when the mill you know, had the bankruptcy auction and all that stuff got sold. I think the city bought all those lights for like $300 or something.
No,
I mean,
kidding.
It was like a great deal, but that cannon didn't work for a long time, and we had to find Gary Mills found the animation company to finally recreate something to make it work again. But it is cool. But I remember the Santa Claus. But what I remember the most, they had switched to clear lights. They were trees that were in the middle of the lake.
I remember that. They looked like palm trees.
Yeah, they looked like palm trees. And then they put those same trees around the lake. You remember they were smaller. And then, of course,
they were hooked to the fences.
They were hooked to the fences.
The fence, yeah.
Another thing I vividly remember around this time of year was the pilot club would do the light of lights.
Well, I was about to say that, the little lanterns. Mm-hmm. Remember that?
Yep.
I do.
All around Veterans Park.
People would say, in honor of Christopher Hughes.
That was pretty cool. I remember that.
And you'd ride around waiting on, trying to find if somebody put one out for you.
That's it.
Yep.
And hopefully your bag didn't burn down from the candles.
I seen some of them too. Another Kannapolis tradition that downtown was always Christmas parade. It used to be on Tuesdays, pretty much right around my birthday. Now it's going to be here in a few weeks on Saturday, the 14th, I believe it is. K-Town Connection, we're going to have an entry in it. We're going to be representing.
Yeah. That's great.
What's your memories of the parade growing up?
Coming every year, you can't live in Kannapolis and not come to the parade. So being here every year with my family, my dad growing up, December's is a tough month for us and our business because we're so busy.
And
it's a huge blessing. But, I remember him working late nights. But when the parade came around, we were always there, right? And it's a cool memory. And now for us, too, to kind of be back where we are and for my brother and I to have our families and kids and we actually have all of our staff over at our Kannapolis store here in downtown, and we kind of have a little staff get together right inside the shop and set up chairs. And, it's a full circle moment kind of thing. Now, growing up as a kid, now having kids, and it's a very cool tradition that, you can't have Kannapolis without the Christmas parade as well. So,
did y'all have a certain spot y'all used to set up at years ago?
Not necessarily. I grew up going to Kimball Lutheran and church right down the street, and, I remember when it would go down Main Street, we could back in right there and just kind of set up shop right there, kind of on the back property of line of the church. And so that was a good spot for us for sure. And, we didn't have a specific spot, but it seemed like a lot of times we'd show up there to Kimball and, you have a front row seat right there and it's a good time for sure.
We used to set up not far down from there where Plant 4 was at. Mm-hmm. When Plant 4 was still there, my dad would park his truck and we'd sit in it and watch it right there.
I feel like we would always be right here on First Street, kind of right behind the church in that parking lot behind the YMCA, like right before makes the turn at the gate down the mill to go down West A Street.
Yeah, because that's Avenue. When it went down Oak Avenue. Oak Avenue, basically. Yep.
Good old days, man. Good old days.
Throwback.
Throwback. Who knew he was going to go OG today?
That's right.
Oh, me. Well, Caleb, what else you got for us today?
Man, I think I just appreciate you guys having us on, just being able to represent our family business. And, thank you guys for having me on for that.
My pleasure.
And again, just DKI too. I'm very excited and very fortunate to be the president of that organization. And if you guys, all the viewers out there will check us out on social media, we'd like to showcase all of our events, Downtown Kannapolis Inc., and just follow us along and help support not only Falls Jewelers, but all the businesses here in Kannapolis. So.
Well, and I was going to say, there's, you all doing your thing, and then West Avenue District doing their thing with advertising the stores that are literally in the West Avenue District downtown. And, DKI couldn't have picked a better person than you to kind of help both sides of that whole effort. I mean, you're looking after the bigger conglomerate of businesses within the loop, and they're looking after, a specific group in downtown. And I mean, it's a good marriage of people. And I think you can definitely help build that bridge and benefit the whole place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, that's you're perfect fit for that.
Well, I appreciate that very, very much. That means a lot. Yeah. So, I'm just very fortunate, very happy. I don't anticipate going anywhere just like you guys, right? Yeah. We're born and raised and be here forever. So, I view my business that way and just the entire downtown, business organization of DKI. And I'm just, very fortunate to be able to lead that group and to hopefully bring success to to his future.
So. And you said something that resonates with me. You said one Kannapolis. You know, we're just one Kannapolis. That's it. And, you know, I know you got competing entities, and I don't know if competing is the right word, but you got multiple people here trying to promote different people within our little community. But ultimately, we're still one community. And then, you know,
everybody's pushing for the same thing.
Same goal.
That's it. That's it. It's community over competition.
There you go.
All day long. So, you know, we all wouldn't be here in Kannapolis if this city and this area wasn't booming. And you know, we all see that there's, you know, no ceiling to this thing, right?
Absolutely.
You know, we're the sky's the limit. And
it's a good problem to have.
Absolutely. 100%. And that's, you know,
my wife hits on me because, you know, if we come down here and can't find a parking space easy or whatever, I used to tell her when we first started dating, I said, and downtown, of course, was still dead. I said, well, you know, if we ever have a parking problem, then we've arrived.
That's or, when you know, you've made
that's
it, right?
When we've done something right. And you know, we do. And it's, you know, people get aggravated. But there's many solutions and many alternatives for you know, overcoming that. And
absolutely.
You know, people just have to be patient and ride the new shuttle.
That's it.
Go to the parking deck, park, you know. But get out there and support the businesses that are here.
Absolutely.
There's all good people.
Yep.
Absolutely. I was trying to get that helmet to fit on the sun drop. I don't know. There we go.
There it is.
There we go.
Old Dale. That's pretty nice right there.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Dang, no chance.
They just shattered the shield.
Man. No chance. Man, cool. And, you know, I still think that we're in the infancy of wherever it is we're going as a Kannapolis community. I mean, I think we're so far on the young end. I know we're a 100-plus-year-old city, maybe 40 official, but, you know, we go back to our great-great-grandparents, you know, that helped start this community way back when in the late 1800s, 1906. But, you know, I could foresee a time here in the coming future when, you know, we still got a lot of land right here in downtown yet to be developed and a lot of spaces. And, you know, I know Ryan and I have this dream of trying to redevelop and kind of revitalize North Kannapolis and Midway at the same time, two places that are part of Kannapolis, you know. And you know, I think that, you know, in the coming years, I think we're going to see a lot more cool growth. And it's good to be at this end of it and, you know, to be able to be the leaders, kind of ushering it in.
It is. Absolutely.
I was talking to a good friend, good community guy earlier, and Clarence Horton, Judge Clarence Horton. And, you know, I think he's one of the most upstanding people in Cabarrus County and been a Kannapolis resident for years and just a great guy. And if you haven't looked at his historical moments, you can find him on YouTube. But he did things about 20 years ago now, 20 years ago probably, of the mill, the evolution of it, how it started, where it went, and of course as it was being torn down, and just great historical, you know, based guy. He just knows the stuff. But he was complimenting the day, you know, how things are now and how grateful he is to be in a community that hasn't just died.
Yeah,
he said, I've held court in communities that literally looked like what this had become, just nobody in any building, and the only thing open was the jail and the courthouse. And he's, you know, and that could have been, I mean, it was us. Yeah. I mean, we didn't even have a jail or a courthouse, and it's just, there was just nothing.
Yeah.
But, you know, and he's, you know, he's in his 80s now, and 84. And for him to say how thankful he is and how blessed of a community we are because of what all's happened, I mean, that means a lot coming from him. Somebody that just, he's, you know, history is his thing, but he also knows that the city is thriving and recognizes it.
Yeah, and so, that's the thing. You know, it's growing up, of course, no one wanted the mill to close. No, if it was still here and we were still thriving like it was back then
nobody knew any difference.
Absolutely, right? But, you know, the world's different, and it's going to continue to evolve. And, you know, it was unfortunate that it closed, but had to do something, right? Had to do something because, again, if it wasn't, then it'd be empty buildings like it once was. And but, you know, we're just super fortunate to live in Kannapolis, to have the city, you know, revamp everything and what it is now. And and Chris, to your point, too, you know, it's I think about what it looked like 5 years ago, 10 years ago, and then I try to even wrap my brain around what that's going to look like in another 5 to 10 years.
Yeah.
And I can't do it. I mean, I have no idea what it's going to look like, but I know it's going to be amazing.
It will be.
Very excited.
And we've been blessed to have good partners to pull all this off. Yep. You know, between Kent and Ken and Peter and Andy at the ball stadium. And,
absolutely.
You know, all these people. And then the businesses that have established, you know, you all and, and the Lingard, the Kyle and Stefan and coffee shop and Kate and Donna and
everybody
and Stormy and, you know,
absolutely
all these people that have just came together to create what we have. Jason, you know, all these people that, that have created this. I mean, it's been a one community effort, like you said, one Kannapolis. I mean, it's people have banded together and pulled it off. Yep. And, you know, a lot of people would have not ever believed it, but it's happened.
Sure. Man, you just made me realize why I love what we do with this show. You just listed about everybody that was on the show during season one.
Well,
just about all of them. I mean, we've showcased a lot of people, a lot of businesses.
That's our point, right?
That's what we're trying to do, Kannapolis all the time.
Yes, sir.
And we got a lot more to do.
And to quote, and you know, to quote Johnny Cannon, you know Johnny Cannon, you know, right there behind you.
Yes, sir.
Episode 4, I think he quoted, he said, we're a phoenix, you know, we were dead and we came back to life.
That's
I mean,
yeah. Damn, was that episode 4?
That was 4, God, bro. Hey. A long time ago. Man, seems like a year ago.
Man, almost.
It almost was. Yep. But anyway, well, man, I think that's it. I'm getting hungry. I'm thinking about dialing up.
They might be closed by now.
They might be, but I'm thinking about dialing up number 10 and going down there for dinner. What do you think? Well,
I mean, you could.
All right.
Well, I don't know if they'll answer, but. Well, might see who it is calling.
They might see. Boy, y'all ain't been here in a while. They'll hang up on us.
Caleb, anything else? You good?
I'm good, man. Again, I just so much appreciate you guys having me on. It's been a pleasure, and just very, very thankful and grateful for the opportunity. So.
And anything, you know, y'all need for us to try to help market or put out on our social media, our future shows. You know, we always do current events and stuff to advertise. Just shoot it over to us, and we'll get it up.
Yes,
perfect.
Sir.
Perfect. Ben, we good back there?
Good on my end.
All right. Well, hey, cool, man. Let's go eat some supper. Caleb Follows, appreciate you coming on.
Yes, sir.
On.
Chris Ryan, thank you guys.
Thank you, sir. Cheers. Appreciate
you. For Rough Talk Ryan, Ben Behind the Glass, Leah Allen, everybody that makes it work here for C3 Films, The Natural Exchange, and just everybody. We'll turn that light off. The battery's about dead anyway.
It's about done.
Greasy Keys, play us a going away jingle, and we'll catch you guys episode 30. We'll find somebody cool to talk to, but 3 for Dale.
3 for Dale.
Thank you guys, man. That was so fun. That was awesome.
We try to have a good time.
Yeah, no, it was great. A lot of fun.